Hey there, in this video we will see mechanism of action of digoxin. Digoxin is a cardiac glycoside and it is used in heart failure. To understand its mechanism of action, let's first see ionic movement in cardiac myocyte under normal condition. Okay, so here we have cardiac myocyte. These are actin and myosin filaments responsible for contraction. This is sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. It has ranodine receptor calcium channel and sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum calcium ATPase. On the cell membrane, we have L-type calcium channel, sodium calcium exchanger, and sodium potassium ATPase pump. This is extracellular calcium, sodium, and potassium, and this is intracellular. This is calcium store inside sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. So this is the machinery involved in the process. Please note that extracellular calcium and sodium concentration is higher than intracellular concentration. Now, as the impulse passes along the membrane, this calcium channel opens, resulting in influx of calcium down the concentration gradient. This calcium binds with ranodine receptor calcium channels and triggers release of calcium from sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum into the cytoplasm. Increased cytosolic calcium initiates contraction, resulting in systole. During diastole, calcium is pumped back to sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. The calcium that entered from outside is extruded back by sodium calcium exchanger. See, this extrusion is against concentration gradient. So this transporter requires energy to carry out this activity. This energy is obtained from downhill movement of sodium from outside to inside. The sodium that enters in tends to increase intracellular sodium concentration. But continuous efflux of sodium by sodium potassium ATPase pump keeps intracellular sodium concentration low. So this is the normal cycle. In heart failure, contraction of cardiac myocytes becomes weak. Digoxin improves the contraction as a result of multi-step process. Direct action of digoxin is on sodium potassium ATPase pump. Here it binds with potassium binding site and inhibits the activity of this pump. So now, sodium is no longer extruded out of the cell and it gradually accumulates inside the cell. This abolishes the concentration gradient of sodium across the membrane that was driving this exchanger. So eventually, this exchanger also stops working. As a result, this exit route is no more available for cytoplasmic calcium. So calcium that enters in the cell with each impulse accumulates inside the cell and also gets loaded in the sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. And finally, now when impulse comes, there is massive release of calcium from sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum, which in turn produces more powerful contraction. As loading of this calcium is gradual process, it takes time for effect of digoxin to develop. So that's the mechanism of its action. Before closing, let's quickly see its interaction with potassium. As binding site of digoxin and potassium is same, they both compete with each other for binding. Because of this, if patient under digoxin therapy develops hypokalemia, there will be less potassium to compete with digoxin. So binding of digoxin increases and it produces toxic effects. On the other hand, if patient have hyperkalemia, digoxin binding would reduce and thereby result in its reduced therapeutic response. So we have to be careful with potassium level if patient is taking digoxin. This completes this video.
See you in next video and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.